Good morning, burned in teachers. My name's Amber Harper. I'm so glad you're here. I'm creator of burnedinteacher.com and I help teachers. I'm sorry, my notes are not working up here. I'm being real. Again, you know that I use notes. I'm going to put them down here instead. So my name's Amber Harper and I help teachers to name their burnout, identify their stage of burnout, and take specific action steps to beat it. Let me turn this down. Holy moly. This is not going the way I planned today, people. I also work with schools and teachers and help them to utilize Google tools and other ed tech tools to help them to step up their teaching game and help their students be more engaged in their classroom. I also host the Burned In Teacher podcast. If you've ever heard it, that's me. And you don't typically see me. And I told you, if you were in the Facebook group, it ain't gonna be pretty today because I'm getting real about some self-care tips and some strategies to get it scheduled into your day. So I offer teachers action, inspiration, and support to help them to actually deal and to beat their teacher burnout. So I told you today, it ain't gonna be pretty. Today we're gonna talk about two ways you can plan for your self-care physically and mentally. And this is the hard stuff. This is the stuff that's not cute. It's not Instagram worthy. It's not something you're pinning or sharing on social media. So for me, I just finished my workout. That's why I'm going live now, because I wanted to share with you the hard stuff. Working out for me is something that I do every day. Physically, I've been doing it for years. I get up right away in the morning, 5 a.m. typically. In the summer, I'm a little bit easier on myself and get up around 6, 5:30, 6 o'clock. But for me, physical self-care has to take place in the morning because it's a time where I don't get interrupted. Nobody can bother me. It's totally my time, all right? I do beach body workouts. No, I'm not a coach. Some days I go running. Some days I do yoga. It just depends on the day. Right now, I'm doing the 80-day obsession again. It's like a year or two old, but I love it. It keeps me strong both physically and it's good for, coincidentally, my mental health. It's just good for me to take that time out for myself every morning. Kudos to you, by the way, for those of you who are teachers and who are beach body coaches. I think it's awesome. If that's your passion, that's what lights you up, that's what you got to do. My mental health care, though, in the past has been something that, just like you, I've pushed it off because it's boring. It's hard to get quiet and not be distracted by my phone or my kids. Or I just think, you know what, I'll sit quietly later and do some reading. But I think that it's something that we need to talk about today. And that's why I wanted to jump on here right after the workout, because after I jump off here, this is the time where I am going to get quiet. And I'm going to show you here in a second, or tell you here how it is that I do that, how it works for me, because my mental health in the past has not been amazing. And I want to share a little bit about that with you. So as you know, if you follow me on social media or you're personal friends of mine, you know that my family and I, we went to Maui a couple of weeks ago. And while we were there, I didn't do beach body workouts. I didn't really use my computer at all. That was a personal choice, but I went for runs or I did yoga outside. And one morning, while I was doing yoga on the beach, I decided that I was going to use my voice memo app to record the waves because I thought, gosh, you know, I love waves. And in fact, whenever I do sit down and do my gratitude journal in the morning, I typically listen to yoga radio or nature sounds on Pandora or whatnot. But I thought, you know what, this is going to bring me back to this place where I feel so mentally strong right now. you know, when you're on vacation, you're able to take that time to just chill and to truly relax. I really wanted to be able to come back to that place. So I recorded, and I didn't do this on purpose, but it turned out to be like 10 minutes and 24 seconds of waves. And the other thing is that while I was recording these waves, I was doing yoga and it was quiet and beautiful and the sun was rising and I get to go back to that place where I felt so calm, so satisfied with everything the way that it was in that moment. So that has been really good for me. So now I go and I play that voice memo whenever I'm doing my gratitude journal. All right. So that's my timer too. It's 10 minutes, 10 solid minutes, and it's now becoming a ritual for me. Rituals, especially when it comes to our physical and mental health, are so important and they have to be scheduled in. We can't just say, oh, I'll get to it someday. It's something that is in my calendar. I schedule that time in. And I'll talk to you in a minute about how I can help you to do that. But to work out and then to get quiet, that's my first morning rituals. That's what I do. So I want to tell you a quick story. When I was teaching several years ago, I worked with a teacher who had apparently a mental breakdown in front of her classroom. Nobody really knows what happened, but so we'll just leave it at that. But basically, she lost her teaching job. The school then decided to offer us, the teachers, free therapy, and which, looking back, is amazing. I can't believe that they did that. I think that's incredible. But what I think about it, when I think about it now, no one took advantage of it. At least no one talked about taking advantage of it. In fact, it reminded me a little bit of when we were in high school or middle school and the school counselor would talk to us about something serious and they would say, now, if you need to talk to me, don't be afraid to come to my office or schedule an appointment with me. And the snickers would arise, right? That's exactly how us teachers treated it. And I look back now and I'm thinking, why would I do that? Well, it wasn't popular. There was that stigma that Stephanie DeLussie talked about yesterday on the podcast episode, The Lies That We Tell Ourselves. There was a stigma behind it. And, you know, I don't need to go to therapy, right? If you go to therapy, you're weak, or that's silly, or who has time for that? No one needs to go talk to another adult about their adult problems. Well, it never crossed my mind to go. And then if you have heard my story, you know that what happened. You know that I had two mental breakdowns. One of them I've talked about a lot. One of them I haven't. One of them was I had a breakdown in the middle of a meeting of a collaboration of teachers. My principal was there. My friend who is an administrator there was there. I broke down. I went to the bathroom and broke down quietly, but came out, clearly was a hot mess. And I had to go home. I couldn't even handle the day. And nothing even happened specifically to me. It was the conversation and where it was going. It caused me to break down. And then not too many weeks later, and you probably have heard this story, my puppy then, Oliver, he's not in here right now, but I went home to let him out. We lived about 3 minutes from the school, and he had made a mess in his kennel, and it was everywhere. And I came back to school in such an uproar, and just, I had completely broken down. And there were people I worked with that thought that Jeff had died. And they called my husband, and they said they were worried about me. And this is because I had stuff going on in my mind that I was not giving the respect that it needed. So just like Stephanie talked about, I had that stigma against that therapy, against taking care of my mental health, but yet I didn't take, and I didn't do anything about it. I just thought, this is just life. This is the hard stuff. People deal with this stuff all the time. I can deal with it too. And the truth is, I couldn't. I didn't take care of myself, then I didn't take care of my physical well-being. Everything went down the tube because I wasn't taking care of my mental health. And this was back in 2014. So here's what I want you to know. You have to make your self-care a priority. Whether it's like a couple of episodes when I talked to Jennifer and Kinsey about scheduling in that nice self-care, that fun self-care, getting your nails done, getting a massage, getting your hair shampooed, you know, doing those things that make us feel pretty or feel good. The physical self-care, going for a run 30 minutes a day, that stuff needs to be scheduled in. It's not just going to happen. At least 30 minutes a day. But we have to also schedule in our mental health care. Whether that's getting quiet for 10 minutes, doing a gratitude journal. And a gratitude journal is just simply writing things down that you're thankful for. Whether it's a list of random things or it's one person. The other day I wrote down one person's name on the top of the page and I wrote down all of the reasons that I'm so grateful for them and all of the wonderful things that I love about that person. And this is especially helpful if you have somebody that you work with that you're not so crazy about, believe it or not. But that's for another day. But here's the thing. If you're worried about the cost of therapy, I want you to do some digging because your school might cover it, just like my school did. And just like I found out the other day that another school that I worked at did, and I didn't even know it. So what I want you to do is, so my husband was actually talking to a teacher or somebody the other day, and he realized that the school covers therapy. And the person he was talking to said, "I'm not gonna lie, I took advantage of it." And wow, for him or her, whoever he was talking to, for them to get vulnerable and say, "I'm doing it." And at first, I just kind of wanted to see what it was all about. And, I kind of just need it. I got some stuff going on. For them to get vulnerable and actually talk about it, wow, that's a huge step. But my husband didn't know that they covered therapy sessions. That's incredible. So here's what I want you to do today, right now, either when you get off of this live or later on today. Open up the conversation either with your spouse or a friend or your mom, whoever. There are two things I want you to do. Number one, just like you should schedule your physical self-care, walking, running, working out to DVDs, Beachbody, whatever it is, get 30 minutes of exercise a day. It doesn't have to be you drenched in sweat, looking like a hot mess like I do right now, but it has to be something where your heart is pumping and your phone is put away. When I go for a walk, I try as hard as I can to just go for a walk. All right, if I'm walking Oliver. When I'm working out, my phone is on silent. I don't answer texts, phone calls, nothing. That is my time. All right. It's good not only for your physical health, but it's good for your mental health as well. All right. The next thing is I want you to call your school district today. Call your central office and ask to talk to the person who carries, or not carries your insurance, but who works on your insurance. Call them today. Ask them if they cover therapy sessions. You may not even need to tell them who you are. Just tell them you're a teacher at the school. I want to know if the school covers therapy. You may find out, number one, that they cover the entire freaking thing. How amazing would that be? Second thing is, you may realize that maybe they only cover a small portion or they don't cover it at all, but then you're going to call your insurance company. You're going to talk to your school to see what they cover, and then you're going to call your insurance company and you're going to see what they cover. You're going to do your research. That's the first step. If you feel that you need to talk to somebody, you got to figure out the facts first. Stop putting it off. School's going to start soon. I know for some of my friends, it starts next week, August, September, definitely after Labor Day. Get that stuff on your calendar now, people. It's so important. So you have to ask the questions if you want to get the answers, all right? If your insurance doesn't cover it, if your school doesn't cover it, then there are different places out there. There are different organizations that offer free counseling. Maybe your church, maybe someone at your church or another organization that you're involved in can help you to find the help that you need. Maybe it is you starting out with the idea of just sitting down for 10 minutes and start with five if you need to. 10 minutes of just quiet thinking time. All right. Doing those things is going to make a huge difference. Number one, physically. All right. You may not notice huge changes in your body right away, but it is eventually going to make a difference. It's the same thing with your mental health. It is not a sprint, it's a journey. And I know that sounds woo-woo or a little bit quotey or whatnot, but it's so true. The small steps that you take now to take care of your physical and mental health are going to make a huge difference in your day-to-day teaching life. And I've seen a lot of teachers start bringing those practices into their classroom. I know that I did, and it made a huge difference for me and my students, not just for our mental health, but for our relationship. So, before I jump off here, I want to make sure that I invite you to my free masterclass. We're going to talk about this stuff, about scheduling this stuff in. It's Plan Your First 9 Weeks in 90 Minutes, totally free. It's August 1st at 12 noon. Go to burnedinteacher.com/masterclass to get registered. And then if you can't make it to the 12 o'clock time, don't worry. I'm going to send you a replay in your inbox. It's going to be awesome. I'm so excited for you. I'm putting it together. I've already started. I'm putting the rest of it together in the next couple days. It's free. We're going to talk about scheduling the stuff that's important, the hard stuff. The hard stuff, the stuff that's not fun. We're gonna get in there. We're gonna get it on our schedule. We're going to be ready for this first 9 weeks so it can be the best time that we could possibly have with our students and for ourselves. Because if we don't do the work now, it's gonna creep up on us, and you know that burnout's gonna set in. So if you have any questions, pop them into the comments. Let me know if you wanna talk. Start by emailing me at support@burnedinteacher.com. And of course, find me on social media. Burn on, everybody.